Hey friends, welcome to this first coding tutorial. As I got many questions about the source code I have published on GitHub, I will create short videos like this one where I can give more details on how to implement some specific solutions. Today, we'll look at the plot of Boolean variables. To remind you the context, I have used this visual for a video and an article related to supply chain network design. The idea is to use linear programming to find the right locations of production sites to manufacture and deliver products to markets at the lowest cost. After setting your decision variable and your objective functions, listing the constraint, so the demand per market, the linear programming model provides the most optimal solution. In this specific case, these are Boolean variables linked to production location. Here, for instance, the countries, India, Brazil, Japan, or US, and factory size, high or low capacity plan. So the objective was to simulate the impact of the variability of the demand on the results. We have run 50 scenarios, and for each scenario, you get the optimal solution. For instance, the green one, where you have in India, one low and one high capacity plan, and in Brazil, you have one high capacity plan. So the model output is a list of Boolean variables. 1 if the location is open, 0 else, and we would like to get this graph. Let's see how we can do this. So, we can start. We import the different libraries. Like the other chart, these are very simple charts, so you only need matplotlib and pandas to manipulate the data frame. I add some settings for the visual in the Jupyter notebook. I wrap the data frame, the lines, to keep clarity and aesthetics, and I increase the number of columns that can be shown and number of items that can be displayed. Then I import the data frame with the Boolean results. So just to remind you, here you have 50 different scenarios. For each scenario, what you are looking is at the result of the linear programming model, which is a set of decision variables. Each decision variable is linked to a potential factory. The factory is linked to the country, so USA, Germany, Japan, Brazil, India, and also to its capacity, so you have low capacity and high capacity. The idea here is to, for each scenarios, where you have different demands that is generated using normal distribution, the model will find the most optimal set of factories to reduce the cost, minimize the cost. So for each scenario, we have a vector of Boolean values, and we have put them in this data frame, and the idea is to plot it. So as you can see, for instance, for the initial one, you have one low capacity factory in India and three high in Japan, India, and Brazil. And we have run that for the 49 other scenarios. So the first step is to import, and then we can start plotting. It's a very simple chart to do, but it's providing a lot of insights. So plot the grid. First, you define the figure. So here I will put a large size on the x-axis, because not 50, but maybe 20. Okay, good. Here, so we want to plot Boolean variables. So there is a special plot for this, which is called pcolor. It takes as an input your data frame with Boolean values. Then you need to define a color map. You can put blues, you can put reds, you have several ones. If you want to know what are the ones available, you just make a mistake here and the error message will show you the list. Edge colors. So I like to add some edge colors. So here I put black. And I like very I like to put a low thickness so it's clear, but it can also impact if you want to do some animation, so depends on what you want to do later. Then So here we can already do that, right? And let me comment this. We can show plt.show. Boom. You see when you have ones, it's at zero. But here, look, India high is at one, but it's corresponding to here. So you see, it's difficult to basically link, right? So we need to have some mapping. We need to see the labels. So for this, we are going to use the function xticks, sorry. And I think it takes a list. And so what I did actually is I added a bit of a space. You will see it's more elegant. For I in range, div.shape1. So here I take the number of rows, right? And I define for the coordinate of each labels. I could say I want it at 1, I want it at 1.1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but you will see it's more elegant if we add a bit of a delta, so here 0.5. Then I need to mention, so I need to put the values that I want to show, so here is the columns. So here's not the number of rows, it's number of columns. Rotation, because you wanted to see them. So since they will be stacked, better rotate them, and I will fix the font size. And it should be good. Okay, we can see these are the different columns. And you can see I put them in the middle of the square, so it's more elegant. Because if you put them at 0, you will see a gap, like 49 will be here, for instance. I do the same for y-axis. So here I do just need to change 0. So here it would be the index. Here, do I need rotation? No. Do I need a font size? Yes. Boom. Here, do I need to put 0.5? Yeah, let's see. Of course, I forgot to change. And yeah, it should be good. Yeah. What happens if I remove 0.5? According to me, it's ugly. Look, you don't know if India is here or here, so keep the 0.5. I hope it was clear enough. It's a very simple plot, but it can provide so much insights. You know, for instance, here, if we have a look quickly, what we can see is that the initial scenario is repeated several times. So it's probably closer to the best and most robust scenario. Here, what we can see is that we have some strange scenarios with only two factories. I think we don't have one with only one. No, here two. Yeah. And just to remind you the context, basically what we did is the initial scenario is based on the average sales of the markets, the average yearly sales, and what I did to generate the 49 is I have put a bit of variability. I took a normal distribution with a reasonable standard deviation around these targets, I mean this average, sorry, and I generated 49 other scenarios to see what could be the impact. And as you can see, the impact can be huge. So then, when you know that probably your demand will fluctuate like this, which one do you take? So for if you want to have more insights, you can have a look at the article. I hope the explanation were clear enough to generate this very simple plot that can be super insightful. But if you have any question, feel free to let them in the comment section.